Oh, I never said you're stupid. I just really want to go home. Please understand.
That's fine. I don't mind. I'll give it to you if you get me the red stuff. What do you say?
Is she telling you?
I thought nurses give it to you anyway.
She's talking about that.
No,
not
that. I'm talking
stuff
about
that I
the real
have.
Thing. Something you can only get in the world of dreams. Now that is something special.
Is it safe?
It's perfectly safe.
Okay. I'll see what I can do.
Are you all right?
Feel like sharing? What's your name?
There is nothing to share. Everyone died. Everyone.
What?
And my treat, my red stuff, it's not the same. I keep lying to myself. I'm a mean little liar. Always have been. This vein, you see, it goes straight to my heart. That's why it hurts so much. I wish I could. Just one more time. But it's all lost now. Everything. I was always happy to settle for a consolation prize, you know?
Okay. Let's ask if she's all
right. Are you all right?
I'm fine. Yes, it's all fine. It's just hard to wait, you know? They said I can have it. You know, yeah? So I wait here. Don't want to miss it. That nurse promised it to me. The one with the red glasses. But I think it's been 3 hours already. Why are they late? Do you think something happened? Do you think she changed her mind? Because I swear if she did, I will hurt myself again.
Jesus.
I swear to God, I will hurt myself again.
I'm sure they'll be here in a minute. They're probably just very busy. That's all.
Wow. Okay.
About these name bands.
Oh yeah, I don't mind. We can swap our name bands as soon as you bring me the red stuff. But remember, it's hidden. You have to follow the heartbeat of the spider. It's right there, in the world of dreams. The world of nightmares.
The world of nightmares.
What exactly is this little treat you mentioned?
It's the red teardrop of pure happiness.
Pure happiness?
They bring it. I drink it down.
How do they get it?
My pain goes away.
How do, like the nurses, how do they get it?
Without it, I just feel so angry. It's like I'm going crazy. It's funny, but I just get so fucking angry sometimes.
Man.
I'm dying, I think. We're all dying, I heard. She said I'd go to hell for it. But I didn't do anything. I didn't know. Does he know?
Who?
Him!
Oh, God?
Right. Okay. No, probably not.
I need the red medicine. I need it now.
She really.
I must be a good girl.
Is
I must
an
be a
addict.
Nice girl.
Maybe I could get you some of that stuff. Do you know where they keep it?
Oh, they have it hidden well. You can't get there. Or maybe you can. I see it in my dreams sometimes. It's where the nurses are. But in my dream, there are no nurses there. I see it, but I can't get it. It's so near, and yet so far. I can still hear the broken heartbeat of the spider's heart.
I'm still really confused as to how the nurses get it.
I'll talk to you later, yeah?
Yes.
Take
go.
The drugs themselves and
be
go
be careful.
There?
They're watching us. And remember, we must be nice to earn the red stuff. Always be nice.
Poor woman.
Crazy. Let's give it to her.
I've found the thing you asked me for. But are you absolutely certain it won't harm you?
Don't be silly. Of course it won't.
Fine. I hope you know what you're doing. Can I have your name band now, please?
Yes. No matter what they say, I do keep my promises.
What do they? You know what? It doesn't matter. Thank you for your help.
All right, let's get out of here. Where's she going? Where did she go? Anne? Okay, well anyways, let's get out of here.
Sorry, Mom, can't let you through. We'll need to see a discharge letter from your doctor first.
Right here.
Are you happy now?
Yes, that seems fine. Can I just check your name band to confirm that you are indeed
check
Anne
it.
Burton?
Oh, all right. I didn't realize you knew how to read. There you
mm-hmm.
go. Can I go now?
Of course. Thank you, Mom. We'll see you soon.
No, you won't.
No, you won't. Now get out of my way.
Me and Susan are the exact same. Alright, let's get out of here. Door. It's locked. Okay. Door. Don't want to go in there. It's employees only. Oh! Hi.
And you must be Susan Ashworth.
Well, perhaps I am.
Do you mind if I ask you where you're heading to?
I was just going for a little walk. Stretch my legs. Get some fresh air.
I was going to the maternity ward. Oh, great.
Give it a rest. I'm not going anywhere.
Miss Ashworth, please relax. There's been a mistake. You have been prescribed wrong medication. I apologize sincerely on behalf of my team and the hospital, but luckily we managed to spot it on time.
On time? You have no idea what I've been through?
Once again, I'm truly sorry. I promise no more drugs will be given to you. I personally guarantee you will have a good, peaceful sleep tonight, and you can be discharged in the morning.
Why can't I go tonight? I want to go now!
I'm really sorry, but we can't legally discharge suicidal patients without a full psychiatric assessment. It's too late for it now, but I promise we'll have a chat in my office first thing in the morning, okay? And then you can go home. Is that all right?
I haven't really got much choice, have I?
Now I'd like to ask you some questions about your life, Susan. You might find them very
personal. So that's
personal,
how we ended up in here.
But it's important that you answer me as honestly as possible.
Fine. Let's get it over with then, shall we? I'd like to go home at last.
Of course. I understand. So, Susan, let's see. Are you living alone at the moment?
I rent a flat. It's quite lonely most of the time. I live on my own and it suits me just fine. I live with a friend. She must be worried sick. Let's say we are fine.
I live on my own and it suits me just fine. I don't need anyone. People mostly bore me. Sometimes they annoy me or upset me. I'm happy with how things are at the moment. I have my little bit of space, and it's my own. It's private. I'd like to keep it that way.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a stripper. I'm between jobs at the moment. I'm a waitress. I work in a cafe. Let's say we're a waitress.
I'm a waitress. I work in a cafe.
You do? Do you like it?
It's okay. I don't mind it. It's just a job.
It's important to keep busy. I'd advise you get back to work as soon as next week.
I will.
Describe to me what your mornings look like. What is the first thing you do each day?
I drink strong coffee and smoke on the balcony. I eat breakfast, cereal usually. I have a cup of tea and read a newspaper. I lie in bed awake. Can't bring myself to open my eyes. I go to the toilet, doesn't everyone? I put the TV on so I can watch old TV shows. Trying to think like what I usually do. I usually check my phone and all my stuff, like my email and everything. Let's say we put on the TV.
I put the TV on so I can watch old TV shows. There's nothing really that I must do. I tend to waste time. My life feels empty. So, in a way, I keep living the life of fictional characters. I keep pretending I'm somebody else.
Aww.
Someone better. Am I making any sense?
You are, Susan. But perhaps you are being too critical about yourself.
Well, I'm just being honest. Don't think much of myself right now.
Would you say that you feel safer at home than outside?
Let's say yes.
I suppose.
My cats are there.
It's not really about safety. I've just felt sad for a long time now. Really sad, you know? Somehow it brings me down even more when I go out and see all those happy, successful people. It makes me feel more like a failure. If I don't see it, it doesn't hurt that much.
What do you think is missing in your life? Or rather, what is one thing that you think would make your life better?
Let's see. It would be nice to have more money, I guess. A good friend, someone I could finally trust. I know it's silly, but I wish I was a bit better looking, maybe? Something to fight for, you know? A reason. Let's say something to fight for.
Something to fight for, you know? A reason to go on.
There's always a reason to live. Sometimes we just don't see it that clearly.
Well, Doctor, I must have gone all blind then, because I can't see any.
Have you ever attended group therapy for depression or some other form of counseling?
Yes, it didn't help much, as you can see. No, I'm not sure it's a good idea. Let's say yes.
Yes, it didn't help much, as you can see.
Just something to think about. I can see you're really willing to open up and talk about your issues. That's a positive sign.
I haven't really talked about my feelings for a long time.
You're doing very well so far. Do you have problems sleeping?
Is that person dead? Anyways, do you have a problem sleeping? Every night, rarely. I sleep well most nights. Say,
Every night. I take pills for that. There aren't any left now, though.
In the light of recent events, I think should stay off those pills for a while.
To kill herself.
I suggest
pills.
You drink some hot milk before bed instead.
Hot milk?
Would you describe for me how you feel at the moment?
Does that actually work, hot milk? Kind of sounds gross, but... how do I feel? I feel fine now, definitely better than before the accident. I feel like the whole world is against me.
Definitely better than before the accident.
Good. Hopefully you can now move on from here. With a bit of luck, you will enjoy life again. Oh. Suicide attempts often have that effect on people. Same as near-death experience. It makes you realize that you're not ready to die yet.